everyone. If you've been following along, you'd know that we have been living and traveling in our caravan for nearly 3 years now. I thought today I'd do a little bit of a caravan walk around and just show you some things inside, because if you're anything like me, you'll enjoy seeing tips and tricks, where you store things, and yeah, just thought it might be interesting to do a little bit of an update. Bryce is at work today, so I thought, why not? I'll walk you around and show you. I'm gonna start with our combi Sharon toilet. I think this is gonna interest people the most, because I think there's quite a big misconception that you do need a separate Sharon toilet. And as nice as that would be, it just would not work in our van. And obviously it just makes the layout a lot bigger when you start doing that. So we do really enjoy the combi Sharon toilet. You don't spend much time in here, so yeah, you don't need heaps and heaps of space. Alrighty, so there is a few things that we do to make it a little bit more comfortable. So we have got this shower curtain. Now we bring this one down when we shower, comes all the way around. And that way, you're not getting the toilet or anything wet. It literally just confines it to this little space. Plenty of room to shower in here. Bryce has no issues as well, and he's super tall. Nice, decent sized shower head, up nice and high as well for Bryce, so he doesn't have to duck. A little caddy here, just fits enough for a shampoo, conditioner, or body washes. And then loofahs. We do have this switch as well. So when we've got it on here and we are off power and water and we're trying to conserve, we can actually just quickly shut it off mid-shower while you lather yourself up, or while I shave my legs or something. And that way you're not wasting water and you don't have to try and adjust your water temperatures again. That's just a quick on and off. So this is actually from Clark Rubber, this matting. I think it was about $80 a square meter or something ridiculous, but it's amazing. So we can now walk in and out, even if I've got socks on or something, it's not going to get them wet. We've got our new hatch that Bryce put in up there with the fan. And now for the toilet. It's got the toilet, sink. I've got this mat as well. So when we do shower, I'll chuck this outside on the floor. That way we're not making a mess coming in and out. And then we just put our toothbrushes and toothpaste in this little basket. I've had that up there for years now. just works. And then we've got this cabinet, which was from Bunnings. And I have just put this child lock on it, because when we've been on some bumpy roads, everything has come forward and actually fallen out. But with a child lock, it stops that. And yeah, that's our combi. Plenty of space in here just to shower, go to the toilet, and that's all you need to do. Obviously, we'd love for it to be separate, but I don't really think it's a necessity. So the kitchen area. We actually do have quite a bit of bench space, I find. So we've got the benches over here and this one as well, which I'll show you later. We've got this basket that lives up here. We put like the cameras in it, keys, and pretty much just storage for like sunnies and cables and all random stuff that doesn't really have a home. We've also got our Telstra Nighthawk up here. It's pretty much just like a caravan Wi-Fi. It just lives up there and then just stays on charge when we're on power. If you're wondering what this is, it's a bag of tomatoes. So these are tomatoes from the plants out the back that were nearly ripe but just needed a little bit longer out of the fridge. So they're just living up there for now. We have this drying mat. So when we do the dishes, we put this here. And then we can also like stand our chopping boards and things up to dry, and it's not making a mess on the counter. It just gives us a little bit more space to spread out. And up the top here, we've got nice big cupboards. So this one's got lots of our dry goods like chips and muesli bars, cold rolls, wraps, anything like that. And then this one has cups, bowls, more cups and things in there, plates at the back, and our Nutribullet stuff. Well, half of our Nutribullet stuff. Then down the bottom, we've got more cupboards. This one's got, I don't know what you call them, utensils, cooking utensils. knives and forks. That one's got like washing up stuff. This one is a really random drawer, don't judge us. I don't even know. Everyone's got a random drawer and this is it. We love our condiments, so we have lots of them and they're pretty much all just living under here. So we've got this whole thing with condiments, some oil, soy sauces, more condiments in here because again, we love them. And then we just keep like pasta and stuff under here too. Rice, SodaStream lives under here, spare SodaStream bottle. And I love baskets for storage. So this one has got like toaster, spare drink bottles, just things so when you're traveling, they're not gonna fall over. Coffee beans.
I'm just gonna show you what's in every cupboard because you're either gonna be interested or you're not. And if you're someone like me, I love to see that stuff. I'm a bit nosy.
Baking things all under here. So flour, sugar. This one's got a heap of Indian spices in it. Because yes, you need a designated box for Indian spices, soy milk, and then our alcohol. So what I've found is we just wrap our alcohol up in tea towels, rubber bands, hair ties. That way it's not clinking and clonking against each other because we actually have had a couple of casualties over our times traveling. And then Bryce's favorite, Diet Right. So it's a sugar-free cordial and he makes up a soda and then puts a little bit of this in and it's like a fizzy drink. Just saves you drinking like Coke or something or just going straight to a beer when it's a bit hot in the afternoons.
I'd usually let Bryce do this part because he is the plumber and he loves talking about water, filters, all that fun stuff, which I do not really care for. But I will show you our filter tap.
This is the one that we have all of our drinking water out of and we've never had an issue. It just has a really simple cartridge under there, just at the back, and I think we change it about once a year. Really cheap and easy. You get these ones from Bunnings or Reese. I'd say pretty much anywhere because they are just really affordable
and convenient. We just go old school. You don't need some massive fancy water filter sitting on your counter. Just that'll do the trick.
Our rubbish bin just lives on the bench here and it doesn't move when we travel because I have actually put some Velcro on the bottom of it. So I just have to line them up and then it's not going to move. So we've got this really nice big L-shaped lounge and then our table with the telescopic, I think that's what you'd call it. Just makes it go each which way. We didn't actually have this when we got the van, but somebody was dumping theirs, their old one. So yeah, we thrifted it and made it work on our table.
Three nice big cupboards above the couch. This one has got towels, rain jackets, things like that in it. This one's got medical stuff, bug spray, sunscreen, stubby holders, games, our favourites, backgammon and bananagrams. We actually don't carry many games with us. Uno as well, which our cards are really old Bali ones. And then this one has got like documents. We've got things filed in these little folders up here, recipe books. Because you've got to think of things like tax time and that. Like you've got to have somewhere to put receipts and things that you just don't really usually think about. And this is where we keep them all.
I'll just swing you around to the other side. This cupboard up the top has got all Tupperware in it. This one's got our spices, salt and pepper, tea bags, and then we've got a little coffee basket up the top there, like chocolate powders and stuff in it. We've got our big coffee machine. Usually wouldn't need such a massive one, but we were using this, or we'll be using this for our coffee business as well when we hit the road again. We've got our stove and then our grill. Grill trays and that under there. We don't have a full oven as you can see, but we do have this extra storage and we just use the Weber for things that we'd usually put in the oven. This one's got pots and pans, saucepans, some big bowls. And then this drawer has cling wrap, our foil, just some random bits and pieces. In this one here, we keep coffee beans, our fan, when it gets hot, we put that up.
And then this one, more spare milk, more electrics. Oh, and there's more coffee beans that I didn't even know were under there. Well, I should really use them up before they go bad. The storage under our couch here is quite big, and we do use it for all of our coffee things. So all of our cups and stock for our coffee business are all under there. We just haven't been doing it for a while. WA make it super hard to sell, and also we have been working for other people, so we haven't been doing our own coffee.
We have 150 liter fridge freezer. I don't think it's very organized at the moment. Neither's that. I put my diffuser up the top, little fruit basket, TV, which we strap up when we're driving. So it always lives up here. And then we've got a strap that goes around it and just ties it so it can't swing around when we travel. Bryce's Nintendo Switch. We've been playing Mario Kart on there quite a bit lately in Mario Party. So that's staying up there. But all these things will get moved when we start traveling. Just near the TV here, I have got this little basket from Target or Kmart, I reckon. We just put remotes and stuff in there. I did double-sided tape it down, so when we are traveling, they just live in there and they don't bounce out or move. We hang our shower towels just up here. These are our breathing travel towels. They're fairly new and they're really good. They're quick drying. A little bit like Tessellate, but Australian. We've just got a double bed and we've got a bolster. It's a homemade bolster. Me and my mum actually made this up a couple of years ago, put some fabric on it, and that of a night just tucks down the back. So we'll move the whole bed out and it'll be up against here. And then we just put the bolster down at the back. Just extends it a bit because Bryce is so tall.
This is my side of the bed, which means I get this little cabinet as well. It's got a little flip drawer here. I don't know, flip bench. I keep hair ties and stuff in there. And then these two drawers have just got like spare shampoo and conditioner, nail polishes, little things like that that I don't need all the time, but is really good to pack when you're living full time. We've got vitamins, and my makeup lives up here as well. And then we've got little Aubrey and my sister's pictures. So cute. I had a couple of people message me when I said I was going to do the tour and say, can they see my wardrobe, what I pack, am I minimalistic on my clothing? I wish, and I'm really trying hard to cull it down, but it's so hard when you like travel through all seasons. So this is my wardrobe.
This is a lot cleaner than what it is half, well, not clean, a lot more organized. Let me just turn the light on. We got a bit of a strobe action going there. There is really no system to this. Just babies, gym clothes, some cardigans, things I don't use, I tend to just put at the back. And things that I'm wearing like all the time or my favorite outfits always just stay at the front. Got so much denim, so many denim pairs of shorts, and then all my t-shirts here. And then my little photo wall.
We have got a few spare clothes under the bed though, so our big jackets and jumpers, things that we're not going to be using for a while, just live under there in vacuum bags, which I think we show you in some other videos as well. We've just got a shoe cupboard down the bottom, so we've each got one of them. I've got the hot water service behind mine, so I do lose a little bit of room, but it's not a big deal because I only carry a couple pairs of shoes anyway. And then Bryce has pretty much identical on his side as well. So all of his clothes in here, socks and undies up the top, and then shoes down the bottom. Well, I'm pretty sure I've covered everything inside the van. I hope you've actually enjoyed this, just seeing where we store things, something a little bit different. If you have any questions, feel free to pop a comment below. I will get back to all of them ASAP, because I'm sure there is things that you still want to know that I may have missed or skimmed over really quickly. Thanks for watching. Make sure to like and subscribe. See you later.